recently. And one of them was at scale 4 from Buttermere. I really like that tape since I discovered it earlier on this year. And the reason why I like it is because it's a really, really high waterfall, so you get a really a big impact when you go in the water. And I don't get that often, so that's why I like it. I suppose the downside of that, I can't really film it for you guys to share so much, because you just get a lot of rainwater or a lot of waterfall water on the camera, so it probably is not such a big impact for you, but it is, and it was for me, because obviously that my hair was blowing when I went into there, and then it just got a bit blurry for you guys. But I want to include it on this channel because it's not always about the picture perfect. I feel that other social media platform is about that, the nanosecond of their whole day, and a lot of people are finding, are judging me on that. It's not always the case when it comes to nature. I don't know whether they say never work with animals or children, but I think that applies with nature too, because you might not get that perfect sunset. There might be a cloud. The night that I did the filming, there was no moonlight, but the two nights before when I went out, there was moonlight, so it wasn't that picture perfect in my head. And it's never really, it doesn't bother me, I know that for a fact, because I live in Cumbria, so I can always go back the next day. And I have no expectations. That's a really, really nice life lesson I bring to my own life, and that's what makes me rich in abundance in another way, that it doesn't matter, that it's not picture perfect. When I went in there today, again, I had no expectations. I actually planned to go somewhere else, but it was really, really busy at the moment, so I've moved to this place, and I didn't know what to expect. I do know that the water level here is really low, but I still enjoyed it. I spoke yesterday to a new friend that I'm going to collaborate with at the end, well, in the midsummer. So I look forward to rolling out a really specific workshop to improve sport enhancement, which is really, really good. I'm excited. But we spoke about how the water is alive, and that's why I love flowing water. It is alive. It feels so refreshing on the skin. So it doesn't matter that this was a bit lower than I thought. I still felt invigorated when I went into there. I'm fascinated that when we breathe in through the nose, when we inhale through the nose, the air oscillates, the blood oscillates, the water oscillates. And it's just so nice that when I say we are nature, we really are. But I just don't want to be disconnected. So this is why I do what I do every day. It's another reason why I do what I do every day. I hope you enjoy my video. I know they're not picture perfect, but like nature, everything is perfect for nature, and it is for me, probably not for my audience. And who invented the word perfect anyway? I don't know. Anyway, I hope you enjoy the rest of my video. Thank you for your support, your likes, and your subscribes. Much appreciated. Thank you. Have a look in here.
Do I go in?
Thank you. thing. Where's the sunshine? It's been sunny here for 2 days in Cumbria. So, there's a little beach space there, so I'm just gonna get changed there. And there's the big rock in the middle, and that's why I call it the donut. Not that you can see it right now, but when there is a little bit more force of the water, it goes round and it just looks like a donut to me. I don't know why I've nicknamed it that, but it's been like that in my head for years. And no one
5 years ago, it wasn't really that popular. I had Monday off. Most people didn't have Monday off to come and join me. It was either I go on my own or I just don't go at all. Plus, I was asking like the huge questions in life, like, who am I? What am I doing here? And it really needed to process the shock that had happened to me earlier on in that year. So nature just, I wanted to be on my own in nature. So I became a bit like a lone wolf, I suppose. And doing what I did, I couldn't be distracted by talking to anyone else. I had to explore and sort of self-discovery, self-inquire on my own. So that's why I went on my own. On the good side, I also got to know many of the waterfalls here because I went on my own and because I went further and further and far and just instinctively decided to seek them out. So that's a good thing. So I get asked, do I buddy up? Not really. I do enjoy going with people and I do enjoy the company, for sure. But I also enjoy my alone time. I feel it's really important just to connect with yourself in your own space. And it's really flipped the switch that I'm not lonely at all. I just enjoy being alone. I think they're very different things, but I don't mind being in my own head for several hours exploring a gully or a gill or a body of water. I quite enjoy that. In answer to the question, I think if you're first starting out and you have people that have the same interests as you, fantastic, you'll join a group. But I'm not going to be preachy, that's why I've never mentioned it, but I do get asked it a lot now. I went on my own, and I'm still here. I don't like to do anything extreme or dangerous. I feel going into cold water is enough. I don't really need to add to that. So I feel I'm the safest extreme person you'll ever meet. So now those two in a sentence. Although right now I'm not on my own because I've got a cameraman. So if you want to see the cameraman. Only joking!